Let's talk about naming acyl halides or acid halides. So if the acid halide functional group is the highest priority group in our list, so it's higher than all of these groups, and if it's the highest one, we're going to name it with the suffix oil halide. So pentanoyl halide, heptanoyl halide, the parent chain suffix goes to the acid halide. Now, if there's a higher priority group present, such as an ester, more common for an ester to be in the presence of an acid halide in a real molecule, okay? Well, then that acid halide loses its priority, and we would name the compound as an ester having a halocarbonyl group, okay? So the acid halide subordinate prefix for the group name is halocarbonyl. And as always with these naming challenges, we're going to circle the parent chain to make sure we don't make mistakes. We're going to write the names of the subordinate groups, number the chain, and assemble the name, checking for stereochem. So let's have a look at when the acid halide is the highest priority group. So we're going to identify the parent chain, and with our highest priority group, the acid halide, we can either take the chain or ring, but not both. So we have to stop at three carbons, and then we can't number through oxygen either. So there we would circle our parent chain. So ultimately, this is going to be a propanoyl bromide. Okay, a propanoyl bromide. That's the parent chain. It is substituted with a cyclohexyl group and a methoxy group. So as we diagram this, we've numbered and labeled our names. We're less likely to make mistakes. So now we can add the non-priority groups in alphabetical order, a 3-cyclohexyl and a 3-methoxy propanoyl bromide. Well, if there's more than one acid halide present, then we would, since we have only the parent chain here and no groups off of that parent chain, we can just number from either side, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And so if we were naming this as a carboxylic acid, it would be a pentane dioic acid. So we could name this then as a pentane with an E to separate consonants there. So I forgot that at first, but we need to separate those consonants. Pentane dioil instead of dioic, and then dichloride, because there's two chlorines on either side. So pentane dioil dichloride. If we have a higher priority group present, such as the ester here, the ester is going to be our parent chain. And we've got a couple of options. So I'm going to truncate the parent chain here to illustrate the name of our group, the halocarbonyl. So this is a chlorocarbonyl group that is on the parent chain of an ester here with a methyl group attached to oxygen. So as we talked about back when we named esters, we would want to name that first group, the methyl, attached to oxygen first as its own word. And then we have a propanoate, but it is a 3-chlorocarbonyl propanoate. Okay, so methyl 3-chlorocarbonyl propanoate. And so we can separate the systematically named chlorocarbonyl group from the rest of the name with parentheses in order to make that clear that it is its own chlorocarbonyl group that was systematically named. We have another option though. So we can also choose to use the new, this is the before 2013 recommendations. We can use the new recommendations by IUPAC to take the full length of the carbon-to-carbon chain that's possible, including the carbonyl of that acid chloride. So it's at the end of the parent chain. We can get that fourth carbon in. And so now we have a methyl butanoate instead. And instead of having a chlorocarbonyl group, we would have a 4-oxo, but chloro before oxo, 4-chloro-4-oxo-butanoate. And so our group names are simplified by splitting up the chloro and the oxo instead of chlorocarbonyl, naming the carbonyl separately from chlorine. Those are the new recommendations, and there's no problem for my class to use either version of the name, methyl 4-chloro-4-oxo-butanoate, or the previous method that we looked at with the 3-chlorocarbonyl group. Either one's fine. If, however, this acid halide is not on the parent chain at all, say we can get two esters in, make sure we remember those methyl groups. I'm going to circle, leaving those methyl groups out so we can name those. There's a methyl, and there's a methyl. And there, we have to name this a chlorocarbonyl group. Okay, so that now it has to be named in that fashion. Either way, we can number 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And so here, as an ester, we would name this as a dimethyl, two methyl groups out front, separate word, and this is a 3-chlorocarbonyl pentane dioate. Instead of pentane dioic acid, the ester is a carboxylic acid derivative, pentane dioate.